The tax has to be simple, easy to apply, and involve no exceptions or loopholes. Now, when we see the chances that the European economy starts a recovery period, when the work on the construction of the banking union is underway, it is definitely high time to involve the commitment of the financial sector to reinforce the fiscal capacity of the countries that has been very much damaged during the financial crisis. That's why the decision has to be taken soon. We have already 11 member states that have decided, declared their readiness to go ahead with the financial transaction tax and to start working on it. I hope that more member states will join, including my own, with a socially supported government. Now they have to act and not to water down their further decisions. We are not in the position to impose global taxes, and I hear the arguments of some colleagues. I am sure that the experience, however, of the pioneers, the pioneer member states, will show the usefulness of this tax. And I would like to bring two arguments for that that have to do with the national budgets, because I hear many arguments about the taxpayers and about the small and medium-sized companies. First, the introduction of such a tax would bring to a relief of the pressure on the national budgets, on the revenue side. And this relief of the pressure would allow the national budgets to reinforce and to finance the economic recovery. Second, I would like to remind you about the Commission's proposal to use part of the financial transaction tax as a own revenue for the European budget. That would mean less national contributions to the European budget, not a bigger budget, more autonomous budget. Therefore, you are going to have a relief on the expenditure side of the national budgets as well. So when we speak about the small taxpayers, about the depositors in the banks, we also have to think that this is going to make the national budgets much easier to manage and with less taxes for them. Thank you very much.